A number of HBCU athletes landed on top 100 NIL list. A few of them you know. Let's talk about it after the bumper. Stay tuned. What is up, everybody? What is up, everybody? My name is Jeff Lightsy Jr. here with the Black Ball Channel Victory Formation. Thank you guys for tuning in. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button, like, share, subscribe, and the notification bell because we upload every single day. Now, today we're here to talk about NIL and HBCU athletes. There's a few HBCU athletes that you guys know of that are on some highly impressive NIL list. Now, one thing, now before I get started, I want to just throw this out here. When Travis Hunter specifically chose to go to Jackson State, besides the fact that people say he's hurting his draft stock because he won't play top competition, besides the fact that people just simply hate him because it was a black college and we know systemic racism takes place in this country, besides all of that, another thing that people said wouldn't take place was that the fact that they said Travis wouldn't get any money because NIL is here, and if you go to Florida State, or if you go to Alabama, or if you go to Texas A&M, or wherever, you get a whole bunch of money from NIL. All I've seen Travis do is strategically team up with multiple Black-owned companies as far as his, at least, NIL deals. That includes Greenwood Bank, and that includes J15 Coffee. But it's not what we're here to talk about. So keep that in mind, though, but keep that in mind. And so, with that being said, let's take a look at the HBCU Game Day article about NIL. It says, NIL, Shaqir Oneal, Shedeur Sanders, athletes with highest value. Shaqir Oneal plus Shedeur Sanders and two of his Jackson State teammates are the most valuable NIL HBCU athletes, according to an index. When it comes to HBCU athletes, shout out to Stephen J. Gaither and HBCU. When it comes to HBCU athletes, name, image, and likeness marketplace, Shaqir Oneal and Shedeur Sanders have the highest value at the moment, that according to the latest numbers from On3 NIL. Both them and Travis and Shilo Sanders all rank in the top 100 for NIL. The index the following information to evaluate student-athletes' endorsement worth, social media following, engagements are a component, athlete data, achievements, performance, media sentiment, or others. Endorsement deals, opportunities, and collectives round out the calculation. The top spot on the list goes to rising senior Bronny James. Of course, it's Bronny James with a $0.4 million NIL evaluation. He hasn't committed to college yet, but HBCUs, North Carolina A&T, North Carolina Central are listed under his status, meaning the website thinks that there are possible landing spots for him. Both programs offered Bronny James as a freshman. The highest ranked HBCU on the list is Texas Southern swingman Shaqir Oneal. Oneal, of course, is the son of Basketball Hall of Famer Shaq. Shaqir redshirted his first season at TSU, Texas Southern, when they won the SWAC title and played in the first four games in the NCAA tournament. His value, according to the website, is over $1.4 million. Ironically, he's only the second highest rated athlete from his family. On the list, his brother Sharif is ranked sixth, but now we know he's a professional player because he plays in the G League. Shedeur is one of the most valuable student athletes in the NIL marketplace. Shedeur Sanders is ranked 18th overall on the NIL list and 11th among college football players. That's pretty good, I'd say. Wouldn't you say that's pretty good? That's pretty good. Being the youngest son of Deion Sanders certainly doesn't hurt, but Sanders has performed at a high level since high school. Four-star prospect at Trinity Christian, he was headed to Florida Atlantic until his father took the job at JSU. All he did last year was win the Eddie Robinson Award of Freshman of the Year in the FCS and the HBCU Game Day FCS Offensive Player of the Year. His valuation is listed at $820,000. So here's the thing about these evaluations also. On three, they have their calculations, but realistically, is that a realistic valuation? Probably not. Why is that not probably a realistic valuation? Because they have Shedeur's at $829,000, right? On this man's on his body right now in this picture is a chain that's probably about $100,000 and a watch that is probably another $50,000. So if his evaluation is only $829,000, how does he have $150,000 worth of jewelry on? Not to mention his older brother, Deion Sanders Jr., posted a video recently that Shedeur Sanders gives Deion Sanders Jr. a $100,000 watch. So we're talking roughly, this is me just guesstimating, $250,000 spent on just jewelry between that video and this picture. But his valuation's under $1 million. Something ain't smelling right. Something ain't smelling right. Let's keep reading. Let's just keep reading. Next on the list is Sanders' teammate, Mr. Travis Hunter, the top prospect in the 2022 recruiting class. Hold on one second. Hunter has a combined 1 million followers, which have helped him. Now, Travis has a million followers. He's not very active on social media. I think he's active on TikTok. I'm not a big TikTok person. I think he's active on TikTok, not so much like Twitter and Instagram. He's not really very active on those things. If he could, this would go up, by the way. A million followers, which have helped him land at the number 43 spot on the NIL list with an estimated value of $570,000. Once again, no, I do not think that is correct, but let's keep going. He recently signed an NIL deal with Greenwood, the online banking company. Rounding out the list of HBCU teams on the NIL list is Shilo Sanders. The defensive back is ranked 72nd on the top 100 list. He was an SEC level prospect. And so if he's after Travis, then that means they think that he is under 5,000. So they think he's under 500,000, but I want to show you guys something and why, and maybe you'll back me and not thinking that these lists are correct and not thinking that this stuff is actually like, not to say that they're lying, but to say that those numbers aren't all what they seem. So this is what I want to show you. And so Shilo, you got to remember his NIL. So if Travis's was 579, that means Shilo, he was lower than him. His was under 500, right? Let's give him 450. I don't know the exact number. I'm not on the list. But let's take a look at Shiloh's Instagram. I want to show you something from Shiloh's Instagram. Let me make sure you can hear it. Let me know in the comments if you can hear this. But this is what Shiloh got from the Porsche dealership in Jackson, Mississippi. Let's take a listen.
You know, being the brand ambassador of Porsche comes with some great things like that. Yes, sir.
So look at that. It's a nice little Porsche truck for Shiloh. Yeah, that car alone is $250,000. Let's keep listening.
You know.
So the car alone is roughly on the cheap end, $200,000, $250,000, the car alone. And he just got a free one by being a brand ambassador via the NIL market. So these numbers don't mean anything. I'm saying all that to say. Now, granted, you might say, hey, Jeff, Shiloh and Shedeur and Shaqir on top of that, they can make a bunch of money because their dads are Hall of Famers. One dad is one of the best NBA players of all time. The other two's dad is one of the greatest football players of all time. Their last name is Oneal Sanders. Of course, they can make a ton of money. There's no argument. I have no argument on that. But what I will say is, you don't think that other players on Jackson State's getting NIL deals? You don't think that other players from HBCUs are getting NIL deals that are? We've already debunked the fact that the On3 calculator is wrong. I mean, I just showed you Shedeur Sanders has given away $250,000 worth of jewelry. They had his NIL estimation under $1 million. I just showed you that Shiloh had a $200,000 car. His NIL thing was under $500,000. Showed you that those things aren't true. I just debunked that. But you don't think that you would have unique and rare opportunities like Travis is getting if you go to an HBCU? If you're able to go to a place, stand out. Now, this is without Travis has that NIL evaluation. See, most of the On3 NIL evaluation stuff is based off social media. And Travis is not big on social media. I think he's big on TikTok, but he's not active on Twitter. He's not active on Instagram, at least as far as posting and doing stuff like that. Not promoting himself a lot. He's doing the media circuits. He didn't do no interviews with none of the YouTubers or CFL or anybody. He didn't do any of that. He like Media Day. All the YouTube videos that are made about Travis are from other people. He don't have a YouTube channel, as far as I know. He did swag talk to the media outlets there. That's it. That's the only place you can find Travis talk. If he did more of that, his NIL stuff would go through the roof. It would. And the same can be said for a lot of these high-level players if they choose to go to HBCUs. So anytime anybody wants to tell you, I'm not going to get any NIL money if you go to Southern or Grand Jackson State, it's just not true. You've got four in the top 100. And I believe that number will continue to grow as more and more high-level prospects continue to choose HBCU institutions. We'll see if it happens. Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. Once again, my name is Jeff Lightsy Jr. with the Black Boss Channel. Also, just one last thing on the NIL thing. NIL, and that's the thing. Shedeur earned every dollar that he gets in NIL. The man went out there and won Eddie Robinson, Player of the Year. He was first of the year in the SWAC. He threw for 30 touchdowns as a true freshman, like 8 interceptions. The man was a baller. He earned every dollar. Shilo was voted first team all SWAC. Whether some of you agree with it or not, that's different. But preseason first team all SWAC. Had some big hits. Is the son of Sanders. Deserve every penny. Travis is going to be deserving of every single penny that he gets. But more people are coming up through the ranks. And more people are going to be getting paid. Keep an eye out on Kevin Coleman. He's going to get some money from NIL. Keep an eye out on Ryan Pepin's Grambling. He is going to make a fortune in NIL. One, because he's dynamic and he's explosive. And he's going to show out on the field. Two, because he's a little more of a self-promoter than some of these other guys. He has a YouTube channel. He's active on social media. Ryan Pepin's is the name to remember. He's going to get a bad body. They might not know of him a whole lot right now, but by the end of the season, SWAC fans are going to know who the hell Ryan Pepin's is. That's just my thing. Also, check out his interview right here on this channel. Once again, my name is Jeff Lightsy Jr. with the Black Boss Channel. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hit that thumbs up button, like, share, and subscribe for HBCU Top 100 NIL. I think that number will increase by this time next year. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hit that thumbs up button, and I will see you next time. Peace.